Table of Contents. 1. The lamb that went smiling to the slaughter. 2. Humans going to the slaughterhouse, multitasking. 3. The sheep are Navy SEALs, training. 4. Humans who forget the death of their children, overcoming sadness. 5. The sheep that do not want the herb that the sheep next to them eats, control of feelings. 6. The sheep and the burnout, stress at work. 7. The humans who forget love, sentimental relationships. 8. Lambs who do not let their mothers save them from the truck, daughters and sons. 10. Sheep do not need to buy a car, money management. 11. The oldest sheep leads the flock, living adult life serenely. Chapter 1. The Lamb That Went Smiling to the Slaughter. As a child, I sometimes spent time on my grandmother's farm. I, a city boy, was suddenly immersed in a completely different world. On the farm there were countless animals, but I really liked the sheep. At first I had the impression that they were the stupidest animals on the farm, but I still loved to watch the flocks heading towards the pastures, controlled by the dogs. It took me many years to realize that those docile animals had reached a perfect balance in their existence. Grandma Bet was a tall, strong, and smiling woman, even though she had lost 2 children and a husband. I didn't understand any of that, I was too small. I didn't start to wonder about things until much later, when discouragement came into my life. When I arrived at the farm, my vision of the world changed completely. It opened up to multiple horizons, so many that it was impossible to worry about anyone in particular, and I left behind the oppressive atmosphere of my home, an apartment in the center of the city. My father had died recently, although I have to admit that for me, the tragedy passed in a superficial way, because I was too small. All around me, on the other hand, there was misfortune and pessimism, because my father's manner of death had been the result of a word that was always avoided, suicide. On the farm the days were placid for a child. Get up, eat breakfast and then walk around all day, but there was something I didn't like at all, listening to the noise of the truck coming to take the lambs to the slaughterhouse. That happened every couple of months. The suckling lambs had to be slaughtered so that Grandma could earn money to keep the farm going, and even though I protested, cried and threatened to run away to the woods forever so they wouldn't take those precious bouncing animals with hair as soft as cotton, the truck never turned around. There was nothing to be done. The little lambs were led to the ramp where they climbed into the truck, the driver would sign a note to Grandma, and the vehicle would drive off down the road, dodging the potholes. Meanwhile, their mothers would call to them from the corral, a piercing, plaintive noise that later in adulthood, I have recalled many times. At that moment, as the truck dwarfed in the distance, I used to burst into tears. Grandma would hug me, and the two of us would look like the only two stationary things in the whole farm, because all around us life was going on. Life around you always goes on, and nothing is going to stop it. After a couple of hours, the mothers of those lambs were grazing peacefully, they seemed to have forgotten them, but I was still sniffling my snot, and some tears were escaping, apart from being terribly angry with the world around me. Why didn't those animals suffer as much as I did? Because they had already forgotten it. That was something that, in adulthood, when I was sunk in a pit of bitterness, I managed to remember, and it was the trigger to rise again and become happy. Forgetting is the only way to happiness. In sheep, forgetting is biological. In their brain, on the other hand, very similar to the one we humans had as hominids recently descended from the trees, there are no neuronal synapses that enable long-term memory, the memories of a lifetime. Long-term memory is a brain mechanism that allows humans to encode and retain an almost unlimited amount of information throughout life. Its formation involves key proteins that activate protein synthesis, such as the alpha subunit of the initiation factor EIF2, EIF2-alpha. Memory is localized in different parts of our brain. Some regions of the temporal cortex store memories of our childhood. The meaning of words is stored in the central region of the right hemisphere, and learning data in the parieto-temporal cortex and the frontal lobes are dedicated to organizing perception and thought. So we can't help but have memories, good or bad. In fact, the first evolutionary leaps in increasing the amount of key proteins in the regions of our brain dedicated to memory most likely happened because of unpleasant events, such as getting burned by fire, which gave the idea that fire cooked meat, or watching a saber-toothed tiger kill a member of the tribe. The Neanderthals who remembered these things lived longer and transmitted this heritage to their descendants, and so the process continued for millions of years until we arrived at this specimen called human being, so perfect and imperfect at the same time. And once we have reached this point, we ask ourselves, why should we try to forget? Isn't memory a fundamental pillar of our evolution as a species? Yes, but there is also the other side of the coin. Our memory can become our worst enemy. Let's imagine that the sheep on my grandmother's farm are human beings. Every time her children turn 2 months old, they are taken to the slaughterhouse. The sheep forget about it, don't get depressed, and go on with their lives, eating, drinking, sleeping, and reproducing. No human being would put up with that. Each and every one of us, irreversibly, would end up ending our lives, despite that hyper-developed brain that has been self-perfecting over millions of years. Too perfect, that's the problem. But at the same time, that EIF2 alpha protein factory also contains the solution. Compartmentalize. I learned this lesson from my favorite writer, Josep Pla. Pla was a man with a smiling face, far removed from the evil that overwhelms humanity right now, depression and psychological malaise, but in one of his books, my favorite, called El Cuaderno Gris, he says that the only way to achieve happiness is to train the ability to forget, and adds, I organize my head in little drawers, one for family, one for literature, one for money matters. Magnificent lesson. Thank you very much, dear Josep. This is the lesson we all have to learn in this stressful, fast-paced, and competitive world. To divide our brain into little drawers. To learn to open and close them at the right time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.